Man, I really need that high. When's my box coming? Oh, wait, check the... It says it should be here today.
Oh, God. It should be here anytime now. Did I hear a doorbell?
Yeah. Ooh. Yeah. About to have some fun now, ain't we? Ooh, I'm gonna crack you open. I'm gonna combine you. I'm gonna transform you. Not all necessary, not option. Let's get open. And see how awesome it really is.
Let the party begin. Now, get your ass up there.
Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah. All right, since I got my dopamine drip, I guess we can now start the show proper. Guys, Sergeant back again, also known as the Black Gentleman. And today, I have a special review, which is going to make my figure of 2019 even more awesome. It is MB11 Guard Armor, Fans Hobby, FansProject.com, otherwise known as Guard Bomber. And this box kind of took me back because it got this nice art here on the side and everything, and a nice picture of the figure in the combat mode, but it's just a plain, very plain paper box. Very strange. But on the back, you can see, I guess, how, you know, you go from the truck mode, or I have to call it more extra trailer mode, robot, combat mode, and this spectacle here, this week-long convoy here. And you also get the three Headmaster Juniors. Side of the box, not much to speak of. And other side, yeah, not much going on here. But I did notice this. I think MB11 is the one I have. Then there's MBA, which I think is maybe the purple. B is the black. And this one right here, I don't know what this is. So maybe we're gonna get a Fire Guts God Bomber. Have to wait and see. Anyway, that's enough for the box. Also, we get a collector card, which is just a picture of the figure, stats on the back. You can pause if you want. But one thing I do want to bring up is it has a stat for wisdom. In the cartoon, he's more or less just a drone. Like, there's no one actually really controlling it. But apparently it's not too stupid, which I guess is good. All right, also, we get these actually pretty decent instructions. I followed them to the T to give them the robot mode, and they work pretty straightforward. I do have one thing that immediately made me laugh. It's a child here holding his eye because, this firing mechanism for the rocket, it hits very hard. And I'm gonna have to show you guys that, it's got a lot of power to it. And like I said, the instructions, it all comes very simple. And the red is what you move, you know, it is very detailed, step by step by step by step. Leaving very little room for error. All good stuff. So, Fence Hobby, you got some good instructions for this guy. Also for accessories, you get quite a few. You get this new head for Jinrai. And it looks very similar to the original. But, it can be opened up for God mode. So take your finger here, pop this up. And you pull out the antenna. I'm getting here in my nail if I can. It's kind of tight.
Oh, crap.
Sorry about that. But I have to kind of like, use a spudger to get these open. The tolerance is really tight, but yeah. You can see here, the crest lifts up, and the tendons pull out for his super god mode. So, that's really cool. That's something they didn't have to include. I'm actually glad they did. And it pops into a ball joint very easily. So, yeah. To go back to normal, you just push these in, push that down. So, very nice. Also, you get two swords right here. Yeah, I'll just put one down. They're both the same. And this is the compress mode. But to open up, you just move the guard down. And you pull out the blade. And you get that sword, which is nice. One bad thing about the sword, at least on mine, the tolerance is so tight. You have to end up taking some type of a tool and pushing it right here, which makes your paint chip a bit to get the full blade out. Because it is right here. You're supposed to take your finger and just kind of sway it out, but it's in there so good, as you can see it. And it's the same on both swords, which kind of sucks. But I'm sure over time it'll get easier. But the paint on them are very nice. Silver paint. A little bit of red paint here to guard. And I think the rest is just colored plastic. Oh, no, take it back. A little gunmetal here. The rest is just unpainted plastic. But they're both very nice. They're exactly the same. In the alt mode, they're pegging under the bottom, which you'll see also. And this little thing here, which immediately takes me back to the whole, you'll shoot your eye out, kid. And I got to tell you, this thing fires like a son of a bitch. You just load one in here. And, oh man, I'll tell you what, I'm gonna grab a figure. I'll be right back. All right, I have my target, which is flywheels. I'm going to load in my ammo, and the trigger is right here. We're gonna go ahead and just aim that at him as pretty as you please. I'm gonna fire at him, and this thing has so much power to it. Oh yeah, I mean it hits really hard. But if you load it up and you're pushing this red switch here, make sure it's always pushed in. Hit the same trigger. Of safety, so always keep that in mind. You know, like don't do things stupid, like you know, point it at yourself. But yeah, you also get two of these missiles, and they're just one hole sculpt with some pepper graphing on the side and silver paint on the head. Let's see, let's go ahead and fire this up. Oh. Hey there, all right. the cannon itself, it looks really, really nice. It's got silver paint here at the tip. Gold paint accents going through. A little bit more here, more silver paint. Nice gray paint here. Same on both sides. Also some really nice mullet detail. And for the shoulder, it mounts on right here. And it also had to hold it by pulling this out right here. Just move it. So it gives you a nice handle if you want them to hold it. Man, this thing's powerful. Also get the three Headmaster Juniors. And I forget names, but I know that's Minerva. I believe that's, that's the one I can't remember. I think it's Shunta. Someone can tell me in the comments. And that's Cab, I believe. And all three are functioning. Let's see, they're both the same. All three are the same. Let's move these two out of the way. Let's just pull some stuff. Well, I should take a best grab all three. As you can see, they're all of them are well painted. You know, eyes are all painted. Minerva's is a nice pearlescent blue, which looks wonderful. Orange painted face and red trim on the sides, which is really nice. And a little light blue here on the crest. Same for Shunta here, if I'm saying that name right. light blue paint for the face. Nice red on the eye visors, nice blue around the crest, light blue at the top of the crest. And Cab, focus. Nice silver paint for the face, blue visor, red on the sides. He's the only one that doesn't have any coloring I notice on the top of the crest. But maybe that's cartoon accurate, I'm not sure. And to transform these guys, we just gotta remove this little crown here, like so. And flip them over and untuck the legs, pull them down. And come on, there we go. There we go. Trying to be very careful with these. They're really nice. Real decent sculpt. They remind me of, pull this down, there we go. They remind me of Genrai and Giga Mecha, as far articulation goes. The legs can kick up not that far, bend at the knee. Legs can go back that far, bend at the knee. So he can kick his headmaster in the face or the ass, depending on how you like it. Both look the same. You can't quite Van Damme or Full Monty. That's fine, given what it is. Arms can spin full 360. And arms can also bend at the elbow. They're a bit taut, or a bit tight, if you say. They're the same on both sides. And, yeah. And it's got some nice little silver paint on the chest, too. It's a nice touch. Give me 1 second and I'll break out some more guys for comparisons, and he won't stand. And here I have all three transformed, and I think they look good, very cool, and very uniform, all three together. And for that comparison, here is Genrai. And oh, I forget. I don't think my my review table is very level. I'm trying to get him to stand with the rest of the guys. There we go, finally. So you can see how they kind of scale together. I know in the cartoon, Genrai was probably like in his 20s. And the kids are probably around the ages of like, what, 9 and 10 maybe? I'm not sure. But I think from a scale standpoint, I think that's about right. I'm cool. I'm cool with this. Let's see. Yeah, I'm alright with this. If I, ah, damn it. Yeah, I can't even stand. But yeah, anyway. Yeah, I'm cool with the scale. Also, if you try hard enough, you can even get a somewhat Breakfast Club pose for all my 80s babies out there. Man, this guy has a lot of weight to him. He's a very, very solid piece, to say the least. I believe I even feel a little bit die-cast in it. If it's not die-cast, it's very, very good semi-esque metal, but I'm gonna call it die-cast. But yeah, the weight is very nice. And he rolls really good, even on my table. It rolls really pretty good. Let's see, we'll start from the front. In terms of a look, I think it looks wonderful. You have a nice translucent blue plastic here for the cockpit itself. You know, with the three driver seats. And a nice, a very kind of, I don't think it's quite chrome, but a very nice chrome-esque silver paint here around the windshields. And this whole piece here is painted silver. Feels really nice. And more translucent here for the, I guess this would be like more headlights, I'm not sure. And you get a little bit of tamper graphing right in here. And some silver, like some silver painted here, details also right here. And as for the, get more of a headlight design here, which can move. Yeah, it later becomes a crotch, but you can move it around any way you like. But for the alt mode, I think it's meant to be tucked down to the sides. And you get red paint throughout here with some more temple graphing. And it's the same on both sides. Turn to the side. You get some blue-white pinstriping, which goes along with Genrai's trailer. So it all adds up to look very nice. But I think this is just all this plain plastic, no paint. Which I'm fine with, totally. And you get some nice rubber wheels with chrome rims. Back of the fin here, this is all this colored plastic, I think. But with tempo graphing and silver paint at the top here, on both ends, on the inside. Turn to here. Let's move the camera up just a little bit. You get, it's mostly just plastic, but you do have some dark blue paint in here on the insides. There's some red to paint for accents, and more of, I guess it's more temper graph, what you see here. And the two big bolts here are painted silver.
And move the camera up another taste. All throughout here, you have gunmetal here, gunmetal here, gunmetal here, gunmetal here, gunmetal here, gunmetal here. Red paint for accents, blue paint for the circle here, where your cannon will place in, and red paint accents all throughout the sides here. All the good looks very nice. Move the camera back down. Let's turn around. And nothing on the back, which is actually okay. I think maybe they probably could have maybe put some red paint here. Like maybe make it half red, half yellow for your brake, you know, for your brake lights. But either again, it's really all really pretty okay. I don't really care. But I'm glad the Timographing did, not Timographing, but the pinstripe did continue throughout the back here. So that does look nice. Now, let me show you guys how the weapon storage works.
All right, you can take both your swords, flip this around, and using this right here, these little slots, and you always want to leave this side out, look for instruction shows, and you kind of just tab it on like so. Oh, come on, there we go. And there we go, tab it in. I'm wrong, you want to use this right here and this right here, my thumb is on this and this accordingly. Just push in. There we go. Yeah. Oh, come on now. There we go. And he honestly, with both swords on the bottom, it might just be my surface, but it doesn't want to roll that well. It's those wheels aren't really catching. But it could just be, I think it's just my surface. But in your case, they do tab on. Yeah. All right, as for the cannon, using this peg right here, and the hole right here, you can just kind of push it in there. It's kind of lightly, because it's actually a round hole in a not so round peg. But I think that works out pretty good. And also make sure that your safety is on when doing this, and you can load your ammo. There we go. Like I said before, you get a secondary, I'm gonna call it a secondary nuke, but there's nowhere to store it. And if also your Headmaster Juniors, if you wanna make them basically out of sight, out of mind, you just, according to instructions, you just honestly just open this up, but it doesn't work that way. You actually gotta open this part first. And what I like to do is I take my finger and press down like this, then pull that down. It makes the whole thing a whole lot easier. And once you do that, you just pop this open. And you have three nice openings here. Grab your Headmaster Juniors, and here's Minerva. And you just, let's see here. Ah, come on up. Just kind of push them inside of here. And once you get them in here, you can basically just kind of forget about them. Unless you're gonna, you know, play with them or something. But yeah, just put them all in here like so. And I'll get those legs closed. And I apologize in advance. This is going to be a long video because I just like so much to cover with this thing. You know, because I have to combine with Jinrai and whatnot, so it's just going to be long. So, bear with me. But yeah. And they all kind of just hang out. Ah, trying to get him in there. He could probably done better. But yeah, they basically stay in there. Also, the crowns can hang up above right here. I don't know if I really like that. I'd probably put them in a drawer. But yeah, and you can just close it up. Like so. Refasten this. Let's see. There we go. Push your lights back. And there you go. You can kind of, I don't know if you guys can kind of see them in there. But I think it's a cool look. Very nice. Now, as we all know, this thing is not just a vehicle by itself. It also combines with Jinrai, even in this mode. All right, you start by flipping your hitch up, which I already kind of have, I got up.
like so, and you turn it like this. We're gonna get that back here. Grab your Jinrai trailer, which I hope you have if you bought this figure. And you, okay, it's kind of hard on camera. Let's get this over here. And I hope my review space can contain all this awesomeness. You wanna take this hitch right here in this motion and kind of just go underneath it. Let's see if we can get it on camera. And you just kind of, if I can keep it turned that way. You just kind of latch it underneath. There we go. And we got it.
All right, and we start from the cab. And we just slowly, ever so slowly, go to the back of the bus. As you can see, it all links up pretty well.
Let me pull the camera out, because this is really kind of hard to get in there. Yeah, I think that looks pretty good. Only bad thing is, it may be because maybe my trailer is Mr. Transformed. Well, and again, my table isn't level, but when I try to pull, the back wheels roll, but my cab back here, my cab with my trailer back wheels back here, don't really even touch. So I don't know what's up with that. So if I push down, it picks God Bomber up. And except for maybe something I mistransformed here in the trailer, I'm not sure. But just as a display piece, just to have them connected, that looks really, really, really good. Man, it puts me in my feels. I mean, this is already an awesome truck mode. Then to have him connect at the back is nice, very nice.
All right. Also,
he not only connects to the trailer, also connects to the cab. I'll show you that as well.
All right. When you connect to the cab, you basically get something like this. In the instructions, it tells you to part the legs back here, and basically squeeze it between the two tabs here. On mine, at least. It's probably my own fault. It's not tabbing together the way it should.
But this is basically how it would look. You know, if I wanted to grab the legs, I guess, and just didn't pull. It's wanting to come off right now. But yeah, this is what you basically get. Not nearly as impressive as the full cab with the full trailer, but something you can do. Also, another thing I want to show too. The hitch is capable. See, it came right off there. But oh well, move out of the way. When connected to the full trailer. This part right here, the hitch, get closer. You do have the ability to turn. So when you turn the trailer, this will turn also, which is a nice touch.
Here he is with Overlord's tank portion, Overlord's jet portion, with a standard, side swipe, the MP car. Overlord's tank component, when combined with Jinrai. I guess I should put it like maybe around here at the cab. So, yeah, that's that. Here he is with Overlord's jet component when fully combined. Man, these things are taking up a lot of real estate now. And here he is with a standard car bot. And you can see how that looks. Here he is with old Optimus Prime MP10. Don't have an MP44 because, well, I just don't believe in the price. I noticed that once I pop the swords off the bottom of this, everything just rolls a whole lot better. Let me see if I can show what I mean. If you notice now, the rear wheels on the trailer now move a whole lot better. So I guess it's my surface, the sword was scraping it, so you can indeed roll it. With that being said, let's get God Bomber into his robot mode.
Alright, here I am back with him all the way transformed, and I figured I'd start from my feet going up, because this is a tall boy. Very tall boy. And before I go into articulation, I figured I'd go into comparisons first to get that out of the way.
Alright, for a sense of scale, to show you how big God Bomber is in robot mode, I have Overlord. Jinrai in his base form. Optimus Prime and Hot Rod. Using Hot Rod as a stand-in for the side swipe. Because I didn't really want to transform that one thing. Believe me, guys, it takes a lot of transforming to get all these comparisons. I'm glad it's almost over. But I have to show one more comparison.
For that last comparison, here is Super Jinrai with the new head added.
is their original.
As you can see, that's how that
would be. Focus. There we go. That's the original head. And here's a new one. As you can see, it's pretty similar to the same. Just light blue-green eyes. And the tendons are a bit longer. And Megan, here you go. Here's God Bomber and Super Jimmer. And God Bomber does appear to be taller. Not sure that's actually cartoon accurate, but who cares? It looks cool having them together. As for God Bomber himself, in his robot mode, he looks rather nice. Really tall. I like the proportions a lot. Only thing I don't care for is the face, just the stink face. Like, he just smelled the worst kind of shit. You know, he's walking to a public restroom and just smelled the worst thing ever. But even then, it's all cool. Face has nice silver paint. The eyes are shiny blue, not pearlescent like I like, but shiny blue. A little red paint on the crest. As far as the pants on chest go, we talked about that in regard to his alt mode. But he has a bit more, he's got an arm typographing there. Silver paint on the barrel of the gun, red paint on the trim of the gun. You know, little details right now look really good. And same on the other side, which you couldn't see before. We'll go down to the feet here. Sorry about that, guys. Sometimes things happen with cameras, so I can't help.
Damn it, camera. Stay still. Going down. There we go. All right, pulling this down. Some nice, looks like red paint and silver paint here. And same down here. Also, it's very, very clean. Not sloppy at all. I like that. And on the feet, you see here we have some little silver paint detailing. And more light red. And I'm not sure, but I think this light blue here is paint also. It could be colored plastic, but it's kind of like paint. Now, as for his, go up again on camera. As for his articulation, pull the camera up here. Yeah, this guy's big, guys. His head can't go full 360 because the way he transforms, one half of the head is stored inside each side of the body. So you don't get a full ball joint. You get like a half of a faux ball joint. So that's really all you get, which is unfortunate, but yet again, some awesome engineering that they could even do that. As far as the arms go, I'm gonna pull the camera right over here. Sorry for these weird angles. You get a full 360. Go out that far. Bicep swivel. Get you pretty much full 360. And hands. Let's move the camera again. Go down. As far as the hands go, you get a full 360 out of these. They are very similar to Jim Rod's hands. They have a fully articulate, although a bit stiff. Which is honestly kind of fine, because this will become Super God Jim Rod's hands. So, I don't mind being a little stiff. So, they're all fingers move. They're just every joint is segmented. So you can bend them any which way, which is really nice. And same on both sides. Arm goes that far. My hand's big in the way. Get a full 360. And bicep swivel, full 360. And again, segmented hands. Yeah, as for the waist, I'll move the camera again. As for his waist here, you get a little bit of a, wants to bend back. He has a slight reverse ab crunch. Comes aside. So you get a little bit of that slightly. Waist. See if you get these skirts out of the way. Let's see. You don't get a full 360. It's mostly because of the wing where the wings tab in right here. So you don't really fully get that. But I think for most poses that you want, I think it's okay. Give, you know. Because let me see if I unpack these wings. There we go. Just move them out of the way. Let's see. All right, these out. And spin them. Let's see. Yeah, see, he really gets some wave of his skirts here, which you really can't do too much about. I guess you could maybe pop them off, but that's not something that I personally want to do. So, as far as waste rotation goes, it's a bit limited. Which is, yet again, kind of like the head. Unfortunate. But given how this thing transforms, some miracle engineering. Now, moving on to the legs. You can move the skirt out of the way. See here. Kick up that far. Kick back that far, move the wing. Bend at the knee. As you can see, he can almost kick his own ass. Almost. And feet can bend at the toe. And guard rock is really stiff. Bend the toe. And bend the heel. But that's mostly due to transformation. Also, he has a thin little piece of rubber here for stability, which I do dig. Very nice. Very similar to Double Evil. He had the same thing. And also, he can bend here at the joint. How often get a full 360 out of that? Other leg is the same motion. These ankle articulation, pretty good, but very, very, very tight. Very tight. But, you know, overall, it's all good. Sometimes it's better to be too tight than too loose. Am I right, guys? Am I right? Now, on to their accessories. Using his, I don't know. I'm almost gonna call it like a nuclear launcher or something, but it's more probably more of a high power rocket launcher. Using this thing, you can fold the handle down and use the groove system, very similar to Genera. Actually, I think all Fans Hobby figures have this groove system. Slide it into his hands like so. You just close them up around it. Matter of fact, I don't think he meant to close them up around it. See, he just holds it. Even though the hand's not even fully gripping it. The way I like to do it is actually just fold this up right here using this peg. Let's go up to the ground floor. And right here, just go ahead, there's a hole right here. And yes, I couldn't get that sealed completely. It's finicky. I've seen other reviewers how they do it, but I got too aggravated and I didn't want to break it, so I just kind of gave up. But yeah, you just use that hole right here and you just kind of push it in just a little bit. Like I said, it's kind of a rectangular peg in a square, in a circle hole. But it holds just fine, as you can see. Just go back up higher. That looks really good. That's the way I would have them use it. More the cartoon itself. Now, let's go back to those swords. And here they are. Similar to the gun, they have a little sliding mechanism. You just slide into his hand. Like so. But actually, first of all, let's go ahead and extend first to give it a bit more length. So there you go. And he holds that so fine, don't you agree? And let's see. As for storage, you have a little peg here on the other side of the sword right here. And you want to turn him this way. Right to the arm and put that right here. Almost kind of samurai-esque. So I think that looks really cool. Let's see here, put the hand out. Alright, put them in the pose. And there we go. Yeah, I think the sword storage is pretty neat. So if he didn't want to hold any of them, you can just keep them both on the side. So that's really cool. And he can not only hold this weapon, but any Fans Hobby weapon he can hold. Matter of fact, I'll show you guys right now. Red and black energy sword to come with their version of Scourge. If you just, you guys will tell you what, let's just go ahead and take this sword out. Just for fun. And just slide this one in. Oops, dropped it. Just slide this one in. So if you have Scourge, you obviously have the sword. And it's something kind of fun to do. So, yeah. That looks really cool as well. And if you have any power bases gun, which I'm sure if you have this figure, you actually have power bases, he can hold those as well. As you would think, because these hands will eventually become Gaijin rods. Alright. So, this video has been going on for a hot minute, right? So let's go ahead and get old boy transform back into armor mode to make him combine with Power Baser.
誰にも褒められない命かけたトランスフォーム傷つくてもやるしかない青い地球守るのは誰だ少年は今
All right, now here he is, fully combined. And first things first, I don't know where the hell I'm going to put this damn thing. Let me fix that sword. Got a little bit in there. Yeah, I got the sword fully extended. Took a hot minute. But man, this thing, man, it... Shit. Now, this is a super robot. This is a super robot. I mean, man, this is awesome. I'm going to go ahead and get the negatives out of the way first. His posability now has become terrible. With all the stuff, I mean, no wrong. All the posability is still there. But when you go to move him, I mean, like other than the arms, of course. Maybe the waist. She's just so heavy now. I would consider this more or less, once you turn him into God, you know, right? He is just that. He's a immovable force. You put him on your shelf and you leave him there. He is definitely what I would call a centerpiece now. You know, he's a thing that you put into a shelf or a case, and you just look at it like, wow, this happened. Man. Other than that, that's really my biggest negative: the fact that he has now become a slightly movable statue. All the weapons and everything can fit in his hand, like I said before. I'm trying to keep this damn thing straight. He has posts on his back, which you can port his weapons. Here, I'll get him turned around. He's heavy too, by the way. He's so heavy. So heavy. I'm trying to, I have to pick him up and put him by the crotch here. Just kind of turn it. There we go. There we go. Now, he has pegs here. I take peg holes on the back, one right in here. Normally, it's probably where you store your swords. You also store your guns here, as you can see. And it's basically your weapon storage. And all four of his guns hold there, including on his feet here. Move the camera down again. The normal guns that were on Jiron's shoulder now go into the feet. At least it's how it was in the cartoon and the instructions show. Turn back around. Yeah. Man, it's a feast for the eyes. And with the new head, it adds a little something extra too. Turn it around here. Let me zoom in on that. As you can see, the new head with the new openings, it does give an air of almost kind of going lagging. I don't know. The way the parts on the face extend. I'm really into that, and you can see your Godmaster Jr. Headmaster Jr. is in the cockpit. So that's all good. Alright, let me get some size comparisons in here. For comparisons, here's how he looks with MP10 Optimus Prime and Hot Rod. And that's how, now, Prime now at this point is now, I don't know what the quick term is for this, forgive me if I'm saying it wrong, he's now effectively a midget.
Before, Jinrai was super Jinrai was already taller than him, but super Jinrai, oh man, no contest.
But this does make for an epic picture here. All right, moving on. Here he is with Fans Hobbies Double Evil or Overlord, and they finally now they're about head to head now. Let's see, move up things up a little bit here.
Yeah, I'd say they're just about even now. But in terms of maths,
God, Jim Ryan wins. Man. I never thought I'd see anything that was bigger than him, but
shit, here it is. And just take this all in. Man, that's nice. Man, now this is why we collect Transformers. Am I right, guys? This is why we collect. To get stuff like this. Ridiculous. Alright, with that all being said, I applaud everyone for hanging in there with me. Let me go ahead and move on to my final thought so we can close this chapter of the Fans Hobby Super God Genrai Saga.
Alright, for my final thought, as you can see, except for you can't get him in some poses, he's just so heavy and got so much hanging on him now. It's not as easy as it was, but you can see, you can get some rudimentary poses. I think that looks pretty good. But yeah, like I said, final thought. Like I said, what the biggest negative is his posability. It takes so much more to get God Genrai or Super Genrai, what Genrai in general. It takes a lot more effort to put him in somewhat dynamic poses. But it's to be expected with all extra armor. That being said, that's really my only negative. The God Bomber aspect is very awesome. It does what it's supposed to do. Truck, cab, robot, armor. So it did its job. It did its job very well. And I have no reason, honestly, not to recommend this. I would say this first. Just make damn sure that you have somewhere to put this thing. Because I don't think I do. I'm going to have to make a space. And even then, I don't know if I'm going to be able to put him in a pose like this. Probably going to be a basic A stance pose when I put him on the shelf. Because, man, this guy takes up some space. Jeez Louise. Well, with that being said, go buy him. Go buy them now. Go buy Genrai. Get them both so you can make this behemoth for yourself. Just make sure you have space. And thank everyone for sitting through this. This has been a long one. I don't know. It's probably pressing to over 40 minutes. Well over. And you are awesome people for sitting through this. I plan to perhaps in the description do a time edit so you can go ahead and get to the good stuff and him combined. So, yeah. All right, everyone who is not subscribed, please subscribe. You guys' views, comments, everything help make me a much better reviewer. I appreciate every last one of you. And also to my fellow Rejecticons, if you guys aren't checking them out, you're missing out. I'll have all the descriptions down here below, so check them out as well. All right, this has been Sardom Hoonspa, also known as the Black Gentleman, out here doing Super God Genrai's work. Next time, peace out.